What's up, everyone? In this video, I'm gonna talk about the Sigma 10-20 f/4 to 5.6 and see if it's still good in 2020. And you know what? It's definitely still a really good lens, especially if you need that wide angle. So this lens was released back in 2005. I'm trying to find how much it was worth back then, and I'm seeing prices that brand new it was about $500 or $600. I bought this lens for $150 used at my local camera shop. I've been wanting this lens for a while now, and I'm really glad I got my hands on it. And you know, one of the good things I really like about this lens is that it's actually pretty compact. As you can see, it fits in right in my hands. It does produce actually really good quality images too. At every aperture range, I'm finding that this lens produces pretty good quality at the center. If you're looking at the outer edges, it's probably not as sharp, but it's actually not bad. I really like it. And another good thing that I like about this lens is that it's actually quick at focusing too. And of course, it really depends on which Nikon DSLR you're using. I've used this on my Nikon D40 and my Nikon D300S. Focusing is actually really nice, especially for this lens. It's not really bad, but it's more nitpicking, is that this lens between 10 to 14 does cause some distortion. I know some photographers like that distortion, some don't, but just a heads up, it will produce some distortion at between 10 to 14 millimeters from what I've seen, but it's not a deal breaker for me. I do like that wide angle look. Not really a bad thing, but it does not have VR or IS built in. So if you're looking for a wide angle lens that has built in image stabilization or vibration reduction, this lens does not have vibration reduction or image stabilization. I guess another bad thing about this lens is that it does not have any weather sealing. So depending on what kind of weather conditions you're shooting in, just be careful that if you're shooting in the rain or dust, it will probably hit in. So just watch out for that. So if you're doing real estate photography, landscape photography, or nature photography, this lens is actually really nice. Like I said before, if you're using a low light conditions, it's probably not the best, but at f4, at 10 millimeters, it's not gonna give you horrible images, but it's also not gonna be the sharpest as well. And I feel like this lens definitely produces high quality images. It is a wide lens, so it's not gonna give you that blurry background. If you're looking for a lens that will produce that blurry background for you, this wide lens is not the lens for you. I'm going to keep this wide lens for a while. I really do like how versatile it is, especially when you go to events, you know, since we're currently on lockdown, but if you're going to events that's in tight places or inside of a house or a car, this lens is really nice. Another thing too, if you're doing videos with this lens, you will hear the autofocus in this lens like this. I'm recording this on my Nikon D3100. And you can hear the lens autofocusing, so it's not going to be silent if you're doing video. So just be cautious that if you are video recording with a Nikon DSLR, that Nikon DSLR, if you don't have an external mic, you will hear it trying to autofocus. So if you have this lens, comment below and let me know what you think about it and how much you pay for it, new or used. If you have any questions about this lens, feel free to comment below and I'll try my best to answer your questions too. And definitely there will probably be some owners of this lens that will answer too. So like I said again, really appreciate everyone watching. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching, everyone. See ya.